Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss about structure elucidation using some spectroscopic techniques. So we have already studied UV visible spectroscopy, infrared spectroscopy, proton and number, C13 and number, and mass. So based on all these five spectroscopic techniques, we can elucidate the structure of an unknown compound. For this, we have to analyze each and every data. And finally, we have to make a structure. So we'll discuss first problem is giving an organic compound C8H14O4 gave the following spectral data. UV above 210 nanometer and IR giving absorption bands at 1735 and 2950. Proton NMR giving delta 1.2, that's a 6 proton triplet, and then 2.6, which is a 4 proton and giving a singlet splitting, and 4.2, it's a 4 proton with a quartet, that means 4 splitting. Then 13C NMR, it is giving 1 singlet, 2 triplets, 1 quartet, and 1 singlet at 175. Mass giving prominent peaks at 174, that is the main peak, molecular ion peak, then 129, and 101 as fragmented peaks. So based on all these spectral data, we have to deduce the structure of the unknown compound. So moving to the solution, first they have given UV absorption at 210 nanometer. So higher absorption value, higher UV value, which indicates the absence of, that is a normal value. 210 means as a normal value. So we can assume that there is no conjugation or aldehyde groups, ketonic groups, carbonyl or aromatic. So there is nothing like functional groups which is giving a higher absorption. Usually electron withdrawing groups as well as conjugated groups will give a higher absorption band. It's a normal value, 210 value, because the UV values ranges from 200 to 400. So just about 210 only. So there is no such groups present. Next, IR value. Absorption value 1735 and 2950. As you all know, 1735 suggested for the presence of ester groups. 1735 is related to ester value, and 295 is normal CH stretching, that is normal alkyl groups. Next comes proton NMR. Presence of 6 proton means it will be a CH3 group. Not only one CH3, it will be two CH3 groups. So the total number is 6, and it is giving triplet means it should be adjacent to a carbon with 2 protons. That means a CH2 group. So we can assume that 6 protons triplet suggested for CH3 CH2 group. And similarly, a 4 proton quartet, that means CH2, it will be a CH2 group and which is adjacent to a carbon with 3 protons. Then only it will be splitting to quartet. So we got a 2 groups, that is CH3, CH2, from these two statements, 6 proton triplet as well as 4 proton quartet. Next is 4 proton singlet. 4 proton means it will be CH2, so total number is 4, and it has to give a singlet around 2.6. 2.6 means it should be adjacent to any carbonyl group. So already we got that ester group is there, that means C double bond O, O. So that is, there is a carbonyl group is there and adjacent to oxygen group is there. So this CH2 group will be adjacent to carbonyl. So we can assume that, and here we are getting a 4.2. 4.2 is related to oxygenated methylene group, oxygenated CH2 group. So we are getting, then 175, it is from carbon C13 NMR, it is giving, which is corresponding to again a ester carbonyl carbon, because it is a quartet. Then we can see molecular mass, that you leave it. With all these data, we can assume the fraction as CH2, C double bond O, O, CH2, CH3, twice. So if you are seeing, this is the CH3 group, it is having the value of 1.2, and it is giving a doublet. And here the CH2 is giving, it is a triplet, three protons are there. So it will split into quartet. CH2 will be a quartet and the value is near to oxygen. So the higher value will get, that will be 4.2. And here CH2, it is giving 2.6 because it is adjacent to carbonyl carbon. And these two CH2, CH2 should be a singlet. Therefore, we are blocking with the carbon which does not have any hydrogen atoms. Now, we can see the molecular ion value or mass of this total compound is 174. And they have given two values, that is 129 as well as 101. That means this total, the actual molecule, but our structure is getting fragmented into two. If you are removing CH3, CH2O, this much portion, we are getting a value of 129. If we are just removing, we are just reducing the total molecular weight of this fragment. From this total fragment, we are getting the M by Z value is 129. And if you are removing this much portion, CH3, CH2O, CO, this much portion, if you are removing and reducing from the total value, we are getting the value as M by Z 101. So all our values are getting correlated with our structure, and how like this we are getting the structure of the unknown compound. I believe all of you got clear this concept. Okay. Next we are moving to another compound. This compound containing carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. They are not given any molecular mass, but they are given only the atoms which are present in the particular compound, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and any halogen that we don't know what is that halogen. And it is giving a molecular ion peak M by Z 108 divided by 110 in the ratio 3:1. IR value 2500 to 3300. And the strong band is 1705. Proton NMR spectra, two triplets, 2.8, 3.8, and singlet at 12. C13 NMR, it is giving a peak at 170. So we'll directly move to the solution. Here M by Z, they are told 1:1. From that, we can clear 3:1 means it is corresponding to a chlorine atom, that you already know that thing. As peak in the ratio, if it is in the ratio 3:1, it will be a chlorine atom. Then IR bands 2500 to 3000 means usually it indicates for a hydroxyl group, and 1705 usually due to carboxylic acids or carbonyl carbon, carboxylic carbonyl group. Then peaks 2.8 and 3.8, and these two are monovalent, so it will be CH2CH2. So we all are getting these data. From this we can got some functional groups, as chlorine is there, CH2, two types of CH2CH2 groups are there, one carboxylic acid is there, and a chlorine is there. So if you are blocking the structure with the values, we are assuming like this. So it is clear because the acid is there, it is around 170 in the carbon NMR spectra. Chlorine is having, actually these two methyl groups having the value 2.8 and 3.8. Usually 2.8 will be this one which is adjacent to carbonyl carbon, and 3.8 is having adjacent to a halogen. So I think this question also clear for all of you. So like this, we are deducing the unknown structure from the given data. So we will discuss another problems in the next class. Thank you so much.